Hi, this is Miss Narca again. This video is a continuation of the previous video about enthalpy of reaction. So in the previous video, we just learned about the essential concepts and the important things that we need to consider when we are dealing with the enthalpy or the change of enthalpy in a reaction. So in this video, we're going to deal with the real problem-solving steps so that we can successfully calculate for the enthalpy of reaction. So let me start by reading to you the sample problem here. It says, calculate the change of enthalpy of reaction of fluorine gas with liquid water to form 4 moles of hydrogen fluoride gas and 1 mole of oxygen gas. So this is just your given chemical reaction statement. And so if you are given a statement of the chemical reaction, you have to do the very first step. And the very first step is you have to write the accurate balanced chemical equation of the given reaction. So how do we write it down? Let's go back to our statement. It says that your fluorine gas reacts with liquid water. So your reactants are fluorine gas and liquid water. So I'm placing it here. Fluorine gas is written as F subscript 2G. You know that F should have a subscript of 2 because it's one of our 7 diatomic molecules, or shall we say one of the 7 special elements. So automatically it's going to have a subscript of 2. And of course you need to include the physical state of your substance, which is gas, so small letter G. Then you put plus to represent the reaction with. Water is H2O and L for liquid water. And then after putting the 2 reactants separated by a plus sign, we are now ready to put an arrow going to the right to indicate the formation of the products. And our products here are, it states in the problem, 4 moles of HF gas. So simply just put all of these here. So 4 moles represent your 4 as coefficient, HFG, and is represented by plus again, O2 gas. So O2 gas doesn't have a coefficient, so this is understood to be 1. And know that you need to balance the chemical equation. We don't have a problem with HF and O2 because it's given in the problem. However, we need to balance our F2 and H2O, so to make sure that they're the same. So that's why I put a 2 before F2 so that I can have 4 fluorine all in all. 2 times 2 is 4. And so I have 4 fluorine here as well, so which is correct. And I need to add another 2 here before H2O to make sure that I'll have 4, 2 times 2, 4 hydrogen, which is also equal on this side, which is I have 4H. And I have 2 oxygen here, 2 times 1, 2 oxygen. And I already have 2 oxygen on the right side because this is O2. O2 has a subscript 2 because, again, it's one of the 7 diatomic molecules. So now this is our complete balanced chemical equation. Now this is our benchmark in order to solve our enthalpy, change of enthalpy of reaction. Now let's proceed to step 2. Oh, by the way, don't worry if you cannot figure out the balanced chemical equation. Sometimes in the problem, it will be given to you. So you need not worry about that, okay? So we need to go to step 2 now. So use the standard data of enthalpy change and use the formula. So delta H of reaction is always delta H products minus the delta H of reactants. However, if you see our equation here, we have more than one reactants and we have more than one products as well. So how do we combine all the reactants and all products together? We simply use the symbol summation. So we know that this is the symbol for summation. So summation of all the delta H of the products minus the summation of all the delta H of reactants. if you've noticed, you have seen delta H with a degree sign and with a subscript of F. Don't worry, they mean the same thing. But when you look at standard data values, you're always given the delta H formation. So that's why you see F there. So it doesn't, it just don't get confused with the symbolism. They're just usually used in the standard values. As long as you remember, it's still delta H, the delta H that we know. Okay, so now, after looking or recalling what equation to use, it's now time for us to look at the standard enthalpy formation values of your given substances. Where do we get these values? These values are given in a standard data table. You need not memorize that. It will be given to you. So for the sake of this problem, I already extracted and taken the formation values of what I need from this problem. So these are what I got from the standard data table. I got the delta H of F2 gas, which is just zero because that's our most stable element of fluorine. I also got the delta H of liquid water, which is negative 237.2 kilojoules per mole. I got the delta H of HF gas, which is negative 273.0 kilojoules per mole. And I also got the last one, delta H of your O2 gas. And because O2 is your stable element of oxygen, it usually that's just equal to zero. So all of these four, I have to put that in place first before I need to solve. Where did I get all these values? Again, it's from a standard data table that you need not memorize, but you just look at it on your textbook or any reference resources that you have in chemistry. I got each and every substance formation values. So do them one by one as seen on your balanced chemical equation. Ignore the coefficients when you get the formation values. You just don't need that. You just need the chemical formula and the state of your substance. Next, the moment I got all the formation values, then I'll use this formula to solve. How do I put that here specifically? So delta H reaction is equal to summation of all the products. How many products do I have? I have two. I have HF and O2. And remember, when you solve for this, you need to include the coefficient as a multiplier to your substance itself. So it says 4 moles of HF. So I have 4 times the delta H of HF gas. So 4 was taken from what is the coefficient of HF times the delta H of HF later on, which is this. Plus, your other product is 1, because there's nothing written there that's understood to be 1. 1 times the delta H of your O2 gas. So in its entirety, these are everything for your products. These are our summation for our products. Then I put minus the summation of all the reactants. So I put this below. I have the reactants here. So I have 2 times the delta H of F2 gas. So 2 times delta H of F2 gas plus 2 times the delta H of H2O liquid. So I just copy that there and then I close it. So everything here represent your reactants here, and everything on top is your products. Now you see zeros in here. So to make your formula shorter, just cancel out those that have values of zero because you don't need them. So that means that you just need to cancel it and put zero and cancel that and put zero. So therefore, you're left with 4 times delta HF of HF and the 2 times delta H of H2O liquid. These 2 non-zero values. And so, let's proceed. I'm going to put the values now. So delta H of reaction is equal to 4 times HF of the delta H of HF, which is here. So I just copy that. So 4 times negative 273.0 kilojoule per mole. close. So that's what's left in the products. Minus 2 times the delta H of liquid water, which is here. Delta H of liquid water, -237.2 kilojoules per mole. Close it. So this is what's left for the reactants. So products minus reactants. I use the calculator. So I have 4 times -273. That's -1092 kilojoules per mole. Then minus 2 times -237.2 kilojoules per mole. In the calculator, you will get -474.4 kilojoules per mole. And because there are two negative, you have a minus here and a negative, the two negatives will give you a plus. So shortly, you can have -1092 kilojoules per mole plus 474.4 kilojoules per mole. So this is now your products and your reactants value. Then I go to the calculator. This is negative and that's plus. The ultimate answer to this particular problem is delta H reaction is equal to -617.6 kilojoules per mole. So that's how we got this answer from our given chemical reaction. So again, the steps that we did are based from the given chemical reaction, we wrote the accurate balance chemical equation. Balance all the time. Your coefficients have to be correct. Usually the teacher will give you the balance chemical equation. And then after writing your balance chemical equation, go to the standard table of formation values of enthalpy and look for every substance as seen on your chemical equation. Get each one of them before you solve to get your delta H of reaction. And in solving, we follow this formula, products minus reactants. And if there are values that are zero, please cancel them out in your formula so that your equation will be shorter. And please involve or include your coefficient as a multiplier to whatever values you have from your formation values. Always include the coefficient. So as for HF, there's 4, so I put times 4. For liquid water, there's times 2, so I put times 2 there. Before I use the calculator to get the overall value of your delta H of reaction. Don't worry for the unit. Whatever is the unit that you got from your formation values, automatically that's going to be the final unit of your final answer. So I hope that this video helps you. If it doesn't, you may look for other resources. You can read your book and look at their samples. You can also look at other lecture videos. I hope that you will pause this video so that you can copy it on your notes and you can have some references later on when you get to solve another set of problems. Thank you so much.